previously on Outside Watch. We depart Madagascar and have an amazing cooking competition on passage.
One chicken tangine coming right up. We have black and lime chicken on couscous with almonds, feta, and tomato bologna.
And we have a sketchy night entrance into the Mozambique island of Bazaruto.
This sketchy is fucking banger.
Good day because it's Thanksgiving and Claire's birthday, so we're gonna go to the beach.
We already went around the circle. You have to say what you're thankful for.
Yeah. Beautiful group.
Yes. Happy birthday, happy Thanksgiving.
Happy birthday to you.
It was no surprise that we were quite famous among the local kids. We'd been hearing some really loud music coming from the beach. After the kids showed us around, they took us to the island's only beach bar. That crazy guy you saw dancing with the kids is Marcus, and this is his 27-foot boat, Samudra. Shortly after we arrived in Mozambique, our flotilla grew by one as we reunited with Marcus, who is on his way south from Tanzania. Marcus is on an insane mission. He is attempting to circumnavigate the globe without using any form of motorized transport. He has been rowing, cycling, and now sailing for the last 6 years. He won't even use an elevator.
I'm Marcus. And I'm circumnavigating the planet without ever using a motor. It's been 6 years from Toronto to here in Bazaruto, Mozambique.
And no cars, no elevators, nothing.
No planes, no trains, no automobiles, not even a single escalator.
Wow. What if there's no stairs and there's an escalator? What do you do?
What if you get arrested and put in the back of a cop car?
That was a nightmare. I used to have nightmares where I'd wake up and I thought I was in a taxi and I'd be like,
oh no!
No, what happened? No!
Jen looked you up online and found some article about you. It says you're one of the greatest explorers of like modern times or something like that, right?
By Canadian Geographic.
Yeah.
No, no. So, is that Martin?
It
did not say that I was one of the greatest explorers of all time.
No, modern time.
Modern day explorer. I was one of the top 100 modern day explorers in Canada.
It's cool though.
It was Canadian Geographic.
It's cool, man.
If you're interested in following Marcus's journey, then you should check out his website at rootsofchange.org.
Looking a bit sandy there.
Yep.
Good morning.
It's 5:30 in the morning, and we're finally going to leave Mozambique for South Africa. We finally got our weather window that we were kind of waiting for. Just today, the wind's going to turn easterly. So this is a Bazaruto now, and it's light today. It's going to be really light, maybe 10 knots or something like that, but we'll be sailing, I think. And these little pockets of low pressure keep popping up, but then they die really quickly. And the next big one doesn't come through until like several days after we should get there. So there's another one there, another little one. It's gone. I think we'll be a little bit behind this predicted weather route. But yeah, it's going to be a little bit upwind today, but then after this evening, all downwind sailing. It should be good. But it's going to be a little bit interesting getting out of here. So we've had to time this with the tides as well. So we have a rising tide right now, because we've got to go out some shallow passes. So we're up in here. Great, the GPS isn't working on the iPad. we're up there. Oh, there we go. And we've got to navigate through this shallow bit.
It's really hairy.
Yeah, it's supposedly it's like 4 meters deep there. But tide's rising. It's all sand, so it should be okay. Down this channel, and then we're going to come out between the two islands here through another narrow channel through this one right here. And then once we get out there, we'll be in deep water and we'll turn south.
We'll be far from the shallows now.
Yeah, well, supposedly it's mostly deep. It's just a couple spots where it's shallow.
So. Yes.
It's a beautiful morning to leave for South Africa. You can see Marcus, he's already pulled up his anchor and...
He's not going to start his engine?
Nope.
He hasn't started his engine in 6 years to move forward?
He's not going very fast though.
He's not going very fast though.
No.
Yeah. It's time to go to South Africa.
Let's go to South Africa. See you in South Africa! Well, we're about to enter the shallow part.
Yes.
We are the trailblazers of the four boats. I can tell it's quite shallow. 30 centimeters?
Yeah.
Are we going off waypoints? It looks really shallow. 30 centimeters below us. It's all sandy at least. Tide is rising. Whoa. 30 centimeters.
They say there's two types of sailors. Those who have run aground and those who will. Unfortunately, we didn't get it on film, but there was a moment where our depth sounder actually read zero. I put the boat in neutral and expected to hear a thump. But somehow we kept drifting, and eventually the depth came back. We're lucky to say that we're still in the category of those who will eventually run aground.
You want to turn around?
Okay, we're back to half a meter.
How much more is the tide rising?
Another half a meter. Okay, right, we're back to 1.3 meters.
1.3? Okay, it's starting to look a bit darker, Chris. Oh, I'm like shaking. If the camera's shaking right now, it's not just my filming skills, it's the fact that I'm shaking from hearing that we had 0.1 below us and then it went to zero briefly, but it was still something, so we were moving. Whoa. Yes, Chris, it looks quite dark now. How much do we have? Okay. Oh, look, I look behind, you can see how bright it is. Whoa!
Now we're doing better now. We got 3.3 beneath us. I think we're through it.
Was that the worst part?
I think that was the worst part, yeah. That was pretty fucking sketch. I'm shaking.
Yes!
God.
Oh, that was scary when you were like, 30 centimeters, and they're like 0.1, zero, and I thought, oh no, are we gonna stop?
It stayed at zero for like a good 15, 20 seconds before it came back up again.
I wonder if
there's probably a little bit of buffer built into our depth sounder.
Probably, or it's like the sand.
You can just calibrate it however you want, so we probably had like,
oh.
It's still a tiny bit beneath us, which is why we never touched anything.
Yeah, we're almost in the clear. Just maybe one more patch of shallow area, and then we are in the ocean. We can sail to South Africa. Beautiful day. It's a beautiful sunrise this morning. I'm getting very tired. Time for bed soon. And Chris will come up.
He can probably still enjoy some of the sunrise.
Down the South African coast right now.
It's amazing.
It doesn't feel like it though. It feels like we're only going 5 or 6 knots, but there's such a strong current.
Oh.
So we're actually doing...
Beautiful.
Yeah, you probably can't see that, but it says 8.3, 8.5. Sometimes it goes up to 8.7. So we're flying along nicely. 14 knots of apparent wind too, just after the beam.
Thailand, not that really that long ago, a year ago.
Yeah.
miles. Seriously.
Oh, you can see how big the waves are. Sun setting over South Africa.
Look how red it is.
Wow.
So we need to dive one more time to make the entrance to Richards Bay. Make sure we don't get blown past it with the current. Right now we're in like 4 knots of current pushing us. But once we jibe, I think we can jibe soon because the current's going to push us south and it's going to bring up our point towards Richards Bay. It's going to bring up our apparent wind more on the not dead downwind, kind of like we're doing now. It's going to be after the beam still downwind, but not dead downwind.
Jen setting up our fenders. So we've got to go on to the quarantine dock.
He's inside his little marina. Concrete wall that surrounds it right here. We've got to tie onto that somewhere.
At approximately 1 a.m. on December 2nd, 2021, we docked Skylark on a quarantine dock in Richards Bay, South Africa. We had finally made landfall on the mainland continent of Africa.
South Africa. What's behind you?
Oh, we made it.
Shillong Bay.
Tradition.
Good job.
Good job. Nice.
Did you film?
Oh, I did. It's still on.
Oh, good. Cool.
I hope I did a good job of filming. Probably missed the whole docking.
Next time on Outside Watch, we check into South Africa and our new crew member Bobby joins us on board. And we set sail down the wild coast of South Africa towards Cape Town.